Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology once again. And from the last 2-3 weeks, I have been making videos on Ashtak Varga, and I want to show you how to analyze every area of your life. So I did a video on career, and also I did on love life, also I did on marriage. And although career and money are very much interlinked, but many people had asked me specifically to show some charts where how to see sources of money, all right? And many others have told to make another video on transits and dashas, and some other people have also said about education and settlement, permanent settlement in abroad and relocation to a different country. So all those videos will be made, and eventually you will see them in my channel, okay? And yes, this is a chart where we will analyze the sources of money. So what I would say is, if you have not watched my video on Ashtak Varga, where I said the name of the video was Master Ashtak Varga in one video, okay? So it is there in this playlist. So if you have not watched that video, please go and watch it. Otherwise, you may not be understanding what I am saying, why I am saying, okay? And therefore, let us kick our money discussion with this video, all right? And as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please do subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your chart, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos, where you will find the link to my website, okay? And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now, which are the houses of money? So I will go very fast in this video, because I have explained the so ways to see the Ashtak Varga points and the houses in my previous videos. So I will go very fast in this. So we have the second house, we have the sixth house, the 10th house and the 11th house, okay? And sixth house primarily shows job and other things. So primarily we will consider the second house, 10th house and the 11th house. Primarily it's the second and the 11th, okay? But we could still take the 10th house into consideration. So what is second house? Second house is the house of your Sanchit Dhan, as they say, accumulated wealth, okay? 11th house is your gains and income, and 10th house is your status. So the more your status is, the more the money, okay? And the more your income, which is the money, more is your accumulated assets, savings, which is the second house. But at a practical sense, it is very difficult to analyze them the way I said, which means on a practical level, you have to give equal weightage to these three houses, okay? And undoubtedly, you will always see that the 11th house is the most strongest, and then the 10th house, and then the second house, okay? So now, let us check from the beginning. So, in my videos, I always said that first we should check the ascendant, okay? So, the ascendant will tell us what kind of a person is this person, okay? So this is the chart of a boy, and he was extremely talented during his school and bachelor's and master's, and he did master's from a very well reputed college in India, from the Indian Institute of Management, okay? So which is very prestigious. But let us check from the beginning. So this is a Aries ascendant, so the numbering is the same here, okay? So when I say one, directly go to the first house here. So there are 28 points, and again, do not go by the 28 formula, the fake formula of 28, which is they say is good or bad or something like that, okay? Okay, so now go to the first house. So check here, what is going on here? Sun is giving 4 points, Moon is barely giving 1, okay? Now why do I say Sun Moon? Because the 10th lord, why do I say Sun Moon? Because the fourth lord and the fifth lord, this will show his education. Okay, so this shows that the person is not very much inclined towards education, because moon is not giving very too many points, because fourth house is the house of education. But because sun is giving 4 points, which is like quite good, therefore the person is very intelligent. So it is like saying a person is not very much interested in studies, but when he sits to study, he understands things very well. Okay, so now that is something related to his education. Then you check the other contributors here. You have Venus, which is the second lord, which is contributing 6 points here. Okay, and Saturn is contributing 4 points here. For Saturn, it's 4. Okay, so Saturn is the 10th lord and the 11th lord, you see here. So now Saturn doesn't have too many points. Okay, he has the least amount of points in Ashtakvarga. So wherever Saturn is contributing 3 or above 3 is a prominent house for that. Okay, for I mean, it's a prominent number for that house. So here you see Saturn contributes 4. That means he's quite interested in his status, the 10th house, and his finances, okay, which is the 11th house. And what are other things which he's interested in? He's interested in Venus, which is the second lord and the seventh lord. So he's very much interested in marriage, and he's very much interested in the second house, family, and all these things. Okay, and I know him personally, so he is very much interested in all this. And this the points in the ascendant is irrespective of the dasha or transits. Okay, so whatever the dashas or transits are, irrespective of that, you will see that this always stays in the person's mind. Okay, now Mars is also giving 5 points here, which means Mars is the Lagnesh and the 8th lord. So his conception of his individual identity is very strong here. Okay, so therefore the contributors are Venus, Mars, and the remaining are almost equal. Okay, and Moon is the lowest, which means he doesn't want to study that much. Or it may show a disconnect with the mother also. Okay, or maybe he is least interested in the mother, or maybe the mother is least interested in him. All right, so this is what the ascendant is telling us. Okay, so now let us go to the second house. The second house is again number 2 here. There you see now this moon is contributing 7 points. This is like very strong, you see. So that means in his family it is very important that he studies properly. Okay, now why am I checking the second house? Because second house is the house related to money. Okay, so there you must check the the numbers very very precisely. Okay, so that means the now the fourth house, which is the house of education, is very strongly linked to the second house. So this can also mean that his primary source of income can be from education. Okay, or you could say it this way, that this person must have a good education to earn money, although in his ascendant moon has only 1 point, you see. So which means he's not interested, but that is what ultimately ends up giving him money. Okay, now why do I say education here? You go to the 11th house, you see again moon has 7 points there. So you see that moon is contributing 7 points here to both the second house and the 11th house. So education is very important. So in my experience, I have seen in these kind of charts, whichever planets are contributing most to the second and 11th, finally the person opens the door to money through these houses. Okay, so now that is a bit debatable these days, because everybody has education. Okay, everybody means most of the people go to school and they go to university, and many people also do masters, and many are also doing PhD these days. So how do you come to the conclusion that education is very important? Well, fourth house can not only mean education, it can also mean the educational institute where you are studying, okay? So that means we have to tell the person that, my dear sir, I know that moon is having only one point here and you are not very much interested in studies, but you must get into a good college. Otherwise, for you to earn money through your own efforts may be a bit difficult, okay? So first, education has to be the focus, because otherwise these two houses are having 7.7 points each from moon, okay? And if you see the 10th house, moon has 4 points here and sun has 6 points here, you see, and sun is the 5th lord. So 5th lord can show intelligence, okay? Now if you check the 10th house, which other planets are contributing there? Mercury has the highest contribution to the 10th house. So 10th house is the house of the status, okay? What is your status in society ultimately? What do people say or what do people think when they come to hear about you, okay? How much discipline you have in life? How much work ethics do you have? How much commitment? How much responsibility can you take, okay? That is what is the 10th house ultimately. So for the 10th house here, if you see, Mercury is communicating, is communication basically. Why communication? Because he is also the third lord here and he's the sixth lord, okay? So Mercury is contributing 7 points. So by this, what conclusion do you come to? This means that if the person has to have a good status in life, the person's communication is very important, okay? And 6th lord is contributing to the 10th house. Now, this can definitely create challenges. At the same time, if the person stays very much disciplined, because 6th house shows your discipline and daily work, then enormous amounts of money can come in, okay? So that means his primary work field will be related to finances, okay? Because Mercury shows finances and he is he's an employee in a very big bank in India, and it's a very international bank also, and he has a fabulous name and fame there, okay? And therefore it is, and he also tells me that although the bank is very big or the company is very big, but still they do not have a very free work culture, which means like you can't just come and go anytime, you know. There are very specific timings when you come in and when you go out. That is because this sixth lord, which is the lord of discipline and, you know, everyday work, doing things every day at the same time in the same way, which is Mercury here, is contributing so many points to the 10th house, okay? So that is his primary job, that is his primary work, which will give him status and name and fame. Now there's another important thing. You see, sun is contributing the next, okay, 6 points, okay? So sun is the 5th lord here. So therefore, he has to use his intelligence, he has to keep himself updated, okay? 5th house shows the things that make you feel lively in this world, okay? And 5th house can at times show your creativity and passion also. I mean, related, if it is related to the 10th house in any way, it can show the sources which can make you feel very creative and very happy, okay? So that means it is very essential for this person to feel happy when he's working some on any project or on any topic, okay? So now that's a very tricky situation. He has to be disciplined and at the same time he has to feel happy and he has to keep himself updated. So if it is used in a proper way, it can be good, okay? Otherwise, there can be a task that, you know, I want to do something, but my job is demanding something else which does not make me happy, okay? So if this is used in a proper way, this can benefit him. Well, now Sun is the fifth lord, okay, and what is Sun? Sun is naturally the Karaka for elders and your boss and senior higher authorities, government, okay. So any projects related to the government can definitely fetch him a lot of money and status, okay, because this is in the 10th house. And not so much money, I would say his status may increase because Sun is not contributing much to the 11th house. You see, Sun is only contributing 3 points. So this means if he takes a government project, is it mandatory that he will earn in millions or billions? No, it's not mandatory. Okay, but people will say that, oh wow, you have got into a government project, it's a big thing, you know, you are a big man or something like that, because his status will increase. Okay, and finance sector, which is Mercury, will also give him a big boost in status because that is contributing 7 points. Okay, so now you come to the 11th house. So who is contributing the max? As I said earlier, it is Moon. So now it is like saying the planets that gave you big status, which is primarily Sun and Mercury in the 10th house, is not very much interested to give you money. Okay, now what does this mean? I mean, this means that the person can have a very big status, which is indicated by the 10th house, and decent amount of money will also be there, but that will not help him to get more finances, okay, because they are not contributing directly to the finance sector, I mean the house of finances, which is the 11th house. Now every job will give you finances, no doubt, but you check the planet who is contributing the most. Okay, so the planet who is contributing the most is Moon here, and Moon is the fourth lord of education. So that means you can suggest this person that whenever you are in your company in finance sector, why finance sector? Because Mercury is giving 7 here, doing some government project, which is Sun, okay, try to take up some role related to education. Try to learn new things or try to teach it to others. Okay, then you will see then what will happen. So suppose he is in a bank, which is indicated by this Mercury 7 points, and suppose he has undertaken some government project, which is indicated by the 6 points from the Sun. And suppose he becomes an educator in that group, okay, he educates other people. Well, then the company may say, oh wow, you are doing very good, you are teaching quite good, and therefore you are also learning, so we will make you as a educator for this group, okay. And because of that, he will get more money, okay. But will he get a promotion because of that? Well, not that necessary, because Moon only has 4 points in the 10th house. Okay, so for promotions, we have to check the 10th house. Okay, so this is like saying you may not be promoted, but you are getting more money. Okay, so it's like that increment of money which keeps happening every year. Okay, so these are peculiar situations. Okay, that you don't get promoted, but you are getting more money. So this keeps happening in companies all the time. I also keep seeing that. Or on the other hand, you get promotion, but you hardly get some raise. Okay, it's a promotion in the name. So now it depends on you what you say as promotion. For you, if getting a big raise in your status is important, then maybe for you that's a promotion. Okay. But maybe money is more important for you, then maybe getting double the salary suddenly is more like a promotion for you, even if it is in the same company, in the same position. Okay, so that is how you know which sources can give you money. So now suppose this person comes to you for a career consultation, so what will you tell this person? So if he asks you that, please tell me which are the sources which can fetch me money. Okay, I want to become more rich. Then you have to tell about this Moon, these 7 points. Okay, but suppose he tells you that I am doing fine financially, but somehow my reputation is not that good at job. Okay, so what should I do? So then you have to ask him that, my dear sir, are you doing things related to Mercury, which is the finance sector? And if he says no, then you have to tell him, please go to finance sector. And next, if he says, I am already in the finance sector, and then you have to ask him, are you doing some work related to the government? Are you doing or not? If he says no, then you have to tell him, try to take some projects related to the government. That will be very beneficial. And because Sun is the fifth lord, you have to, you can't just do it because somebody is telling. You know, you have to feel at an internal level that this is something which I should do. It should be your passion, okay, not just your daily job, okay. That's not the way fifth house works, okay. So these are the ways you can know that which sources will give you money. And after that, after 2 years, if he says, oh sir, I got a promotion, I am very happy, my life is great, now can you tell me about my money, how can I get more money? So then you have to check the second house. You check the second house and then you check the 11th house. There you see moon is contributing 7c. All the other planets in the second house are contributing 2, 3, 3, 4, 3, like this. Okay, but moon is contributing 7, and here also you see it is the same situation, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 3, and moon is 7. So ultimately, moon is controlling the entire finances in this chart, which is the lord of education. Okay, and moon is the Cancer is the sign where Jupiter gets exalted. So Cancer can also show teaching at times. Okay, so he must take up teaching. Only then he will be able to earn more money. He will be able to fetch more projects for his company, for his bank, for his consultancy, and by that he will be making lots of money. Okay, and in my experience, I have talked to him, and he is very happy financially also. He's satisfied, and he's already into banks, as I said, and he's already into some government projects. But I have to also tell him that go towards the educational sector. Within that, you will flourish much more in your life. Okay, and he's already doing something like that, but not full time. Okay, so that is what you have to see. And you have to know, and you have to try to understand which are the sources that can give you money. Okay, so it depends on what the person is asking. If he's asking about status, check the 10th house. If he's asking about money, check the 2nd and the 11th. Okay, and yes, this person is continuing his job, and he's very happy. And if you see the there's another thing which I have observed in my experience. If the lords of these three houses, the second lord, 10th lord and 11th lord, they are contributing more points to each other's houses, okay, then also it is very good, I have seen. Okay, so now here if you see, Venus is contributing how many points? Venus is contributing 3 points, and here Venus is contributing 4 points, and here to Taurus, Venus is contributing 4 points. So that's decent enough, I would say, as the second lord. Then what about the 10th lord? Now here 10th lord and 11th lord is also Saturn. Okay, so Saturn is contributing 3 here and 3 here. So this rule is not quite fitting into his chart. So therefore, the conclusion is that the transits, if they are happening in the 2nd, 10th and 11th houses for him, okay, then the chances that he will get some abnormal amount of money or sudden promotion or something like that is very less. Okay, but suppose Venus and Saturn would be contributing, like, you know, 5 points or 7 or 8 points in these houses, okay, I mean individually in these houses, then any transit which comes to the 10th house or the 11th house or the 2nd house will boost his finances like anything, in a way which nobody can imagine. But now here the contribution is very less. Okay, it's average, not that great. So he has to work hard, and his rise will be gradual in life. And what happens ultimately will be dependent on the dasas and what kind of placements the dasa lords are in and what is going on. And the current job which he got was in Mercury Mahadasha and Venus Antardasha. Okay, that time he got this job, and because these two are natural benefics, so these two, whenever dasha of natural benefics come, the ambience is very good. Okay, so ambience means like, because it's a big bank, you know, big company, so there's a lot of perks which he got. You know, he got a car to ride and so many other benefits and so many other allowances. Okay, because these two are great benefics, Mercury and Venus. Okay, and the company size is also big, and food is free there, a lot of other allowances are there, phone bill is there, and so many other investment schemes are there. But suppose the dasa planets were somebody like Saturn, Rahu or Ketu, which are natural malefics, then it could happen that the place where he is working is not very good as per ambience. It can be it could have people who you don't get along well with. Okay, these kind of things could happen, or maybe there are no perks, or you are working too much and not getting much. These kind of things can happen. Okay, but how much money you get, what will be your status, that will all depend on where the lords of the where the dasha lords are sitting. And in his case, Mercury and Venus are reasonably well placed, and therefore he also got a very good job, and now he's quite happy. Okay, so there you go. This is very similar to the career video which I made, but here I focused exclusively on the second house and the 11th house, and I showed you how to gain more profit from these two houses. Okay, so you can also check in your chart, and you can very easily come to the conclusions. Okay, and as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation from me, then you can go down to the description section of my videos to book a reading with me. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Thank you very much. See you soon.